Hello, my name is Akanksha Kavade. In this presentation, I am going to talk about exploring static methods in Java. So, first of all, what is static method? If any method is declared with keyword static, then that method is called a static method. For example, main method. Static method perform a task that does not depend on the contents of any object. So now, let's have a look at the features of static method. First of all, it does not require object of any class to call. The static method is called by the class name. It can access only the static attributes of the class. In both static and non-static class, static method is directly accessible. Now, let's see the syntax to declare static method. So here we can see the access modifier. Then there is a keyword static followed by the void. Void is nothing but the return type. Then you can see the method name and followed by the parameters in the pair of parentheses. You can add any number of parameters. Then there is a then in the curly braces there is a body of the method. Then after seeing the syntax to declare the static method, let's see the syntax to call the static method. It is very simple. The syntax to call static method is that class name dot method name followed by a pair of parenthesis and then semicolon. After taking the brief information about static method, let us see a program for a static method. So here is a simple Java program to illustrate the calling of a static method. In this class, there is a class 1 named as helper. In helper class, we are declaring a static method named as sum with parameters a and b of data type integers. The static method is simply performing the addition and returning it. Below that we can see the name class 2 name as caller. In this caller class we are initializing the two integers n and m with values 3 and 6. After that we are calling the static method. As the static method is called, it adds two integers which are passed to it and it simply storing it in the new integer s. After this we are simply printing the sum. So the expected output of this program should be sum is 9. So thank you for your precious time. Have a nice day.